Hey friends, it's Brian here, and it's time for another session with my junky truck. It won't be junky when I'm done with it, but right now, yeah, it's kind of junky. Anyway, so I am relocating the glow plug controller over here. And so what I'm going to do in this video is make the cable that goes from here to there. So let's figure out how wide that or how long that is. Go from here along this route here and run under there. All right, let's go make some cables. So we're going to trim it to length. And then we're going to make a second one. So the amp draw should be around 150 amps, and these cables should be rated for about 80 apiece. And that's a maximum amp draw. It'll go down as the plugs heat up. This is number 6 welding cable, which has more than enough capacity. All right, let's put some ends on these. Okay, so the way this works is you take your terminal and you decide how much you want to cut the insulation back. And I'm just using a razor blade. There's nothing magical about what I'm doing. Intentionally not putting a lot of pressure on this because I don't want to cut a bunch of the wires. Do this again. So now let's crimp these. Just push that in there. And then you use a hammer to do a set strike. And then once it's set, you want to crimp it with a few more hard hits. It's done. Wish I'd found this crimping style a little while back, because this is way better than anything else I've tried for large crimps. And it works on a large variety of sizes. I like my heat shrink to fit as tightly as possible. In this case, 3/8 seems to be about right. So I'm going to heat shrink these real quick. We'll be right back. Thank you. That's it for now. You will notice some adhesive seeping out. This is marine grade heat shrink, so it has adhesive on the inside. Makes a nice watertight seal, keeps corrosion out. Let's go get these installed. Okay, so these need to connect to the end of the sensor, or there's this resistor built in. Essentially the way this works is it's comparing the input and output voltages to determine the resistance of the glow plugs, and that gives it an idea what the temperature is, because the temperature changes. Yeah, we're a little tight. And let me go find a wrench for this. All right, this is a 5/8 inch. This nice and snug. All right, and then I'm gonna start securing the wires as I go. there is more that we can do it this way. Let me reposition the camera. So we're going to come in like this, and I don't think that the covers are going to fit on, so whatever. Thank you. Alright, there we go. That should deliver 160 amps to these two points, or 80 amps to each point. Now, if you want to see how I fabricated this mount, there's a video that's specific to that. So feel free to check that out. It's in the playlist. That's how I organize my videos. That's good for now. That's where I want to route that. Okay. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. So we've run power from the glow plug controller to this terminal block. The next video in this series is going to be building new harnesses for the glow plugs. So that's what I'm going to get started on. Thanks for watching.